All right, Sanitary District number two is being called to order at 7:20 PM. Mike Woods for roll call.
Here.
Mark Strobel's absent. Jack Anderson's here. Andy Peters.
Here.
Dean Culbertson.
Here.
Good. Agenda was properly noticed. Any questions on the agenda or is there a motion?
To approve agenda.
Second.
Mike's given a motion to approve. Dean's a second. All in favor to approve the agenda, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, say no. Motion carries, agenda is approved. Public comment forum section. Is there anybody here for that? Since there's not, I'll make a motion to close. Needs a second.
Second.
Mike Woods given the second. All in favor to close the public comment forum, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, say no. Motion carries, public comment forum section is closed. Consent agenda has the meeting minutes from July 9th, the vouchers for August, and stormwater superintendent report. Any questions on that, or is there a motion?
Move.
Second. All in favor to approve the consent agenda, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, say no. Consent agenda is approved. Five is not necessary. Item 6A, discussion and possible action for rain garden retrofits, project awarding. So it looks like you're looking for approval for the rain garden retrofits contract to Vinton and authorizing a change order, removing the municipal garage rain garden from the contract.
That's correct.
Any questions or a motion for this? I'll second. So Dean's made a motion, assuming to approve the awarding of 2018 street rain garden retrofits contract to Vinton and authorize change order number one to remove Schedule A, which is the municipal garage rain gardens. This is for $391,710.91. Any questions? We'll go forward with our vote on the motion as it was just stated. All in favor to approve, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, say no. Motion carries. 6A is approved. 6B, this is discussion and possible action. The Crestview second phase storm sewer pipe and reinstall. Ryan, it's your opportunity.
Ryan McClure, N972 Quarry Rim Road. This pipe that's proposed in here actually runs through easement on my property. Before I purchased this lot, it was made aware to Schiller that there was elevation issues. I've had the runaround for 2 years. I'd like to see this get corrected. So I support the project. Thank you.
Okay.
What are the issues? Is it not deep enough
or? There was supposed to be a 9 inches of pitch between the one road culvert that comes under and the one that goes to the south. There was about 3 inches of pitch between the two. The water just sits in there. The pipe that runs the whole length of the property, that which is in the scope of work here. If you look into it, it's crooked, it's bent, it's all over the place. More than 50% of the pipe was exposed when I purchased the lot. If you put a level in it for the 6 foot level, it back pitches at least 3 inches, so the water won't go into the pipe. It then builds up in the front area there.
There's also very, very limited clear cover in this pipe, so what's going to happen over time is with the frost, it's kind of to winters, this pipe's going to keep out of the ground. There's, I would say, anywhere from 6 inches approximately cover on top of the pipe, so the portions that, you know, are potentially pitched correctly over time are going to be back pitched because the frost will keep it out of the ground. You guys probably have driven down Spring Road, intersection of Spring and Julius. I mean, very similar situation with a culvert that you can't keep in the ground. I mean, they got sandbags on top of it. You can't fight the strength of frozen water. I mean, you can damage a lot of stuff. And part of this is since there is no, the homes behind it, or the lots behind it have not been sold yet, we'll be able to get access from the south side to get into this project. So it'll leave for a little bit less restoration and a lot easier because the ditches there are very steep to get equipment in and out. We've been in contact with the developer and also the engineer for Crestview South to make them aware of what our intentions were. Because we'd actually be tying into a inlet structure that is currently owned by them, but we will be accepting that infrastructure if we do decide to accept Crestview South. They're aware of it. They have no concerns. It's actually going to potentially help drainage in that area with keeping it being piped rather than overland flow, so you're not going to have the cattail situations and stuff like that.
Is there any impact to the property to the east? It's part of doing this project or, you know, access?
So
it looks like your home is on just the west side of where this pipe runs?
Correct.
Both homes will, I mean, we do have an easement through the area.
Okay.
Both homes, there will be some impact to them just because, you know, obviously we're going to have to clear up their lawn. Unfortunately, the home to the east, we did talk with the property owner. They do have a retaining wall that's about 2 feet into the easement. We did make them aware that you know, you're not allowed to have a retaining wall in the easement for one, and it's their responsibility if there's any damage to it, if they need to remove it or reinstall it.
Okay.
Our intentions would be to hopefully be able to work around it.
Is town staff doing this project?
Yes, sir.
Correct.
Okay.
We would intend to rent a mid-sized excavator, track excavator, to do the work just because of the tight constraints between the houses, just due to some maneuverability to rotate on an access point.
I'm going to make a motion to approve the Crestview second phase storm sewer pipe reinstall and as described for $6,900.
Second.
Thank you, Dean. Any other questions or comments? Pardon? Yeah, so I just read.
$4,000, isn't it?
Yeah.
No, something.
What did I read?
So you have.
It's actually, so the Crestview mini storm is actually out of order. So did you read the Crestview's?
Second phase stormwater sewer pipe reinstall.
For $6,900?
Yes. Good.
The attachments may have been out of order.
Okay.
I think that's it.
So my motion still stands. Who gave the second?
Second still stands.
Dean, okay. Any other questions or comments? Not hearing any, so let's go forward with our vote. Motion was to approve the Crestview's second phase storm sewer pipe reinstall for $6,900. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed say no. Motion carries. 6B is approved. 6C, this is discussion and possible action for Crestview mini storm extension. Okay. Is this in front of the where that pond is?
No.
No, I'm not looking at the right spot.
So just to give a little bit of background,
okay.
We did install in Crestview South, since there was a lot of wetlands and there was very high groundwater in that area, we installed the mini storm sewer system. We didn't install, the developer installed the mini storm sewer system, so that way it would aid in keeping ditches dry, not have any issues with, you know, frozen culverts and stuff like that. The residents would then tie their sub pumps into it because a lot of these houses are going to have continuous sub pump. Their sub pumps are going to run continuously because of the high groundwater. So this would alleviate that. This memo is to actually extend that mini storm sewer system to the north and connect to three other homes that are listed there in 982 and 988. six. So essentially, it would give those property owners the opportunity to connect into that system to help keep their ditches dry.
Just to also point out, these are existing homes along that area, so we would ask for participation, cost share participation from those residents in order to do that. But this is the cost, obviously, to do the entire project with the individual property owners contributing their portion of the total bill.
So you're gonna probably pull out culverts, right?
No.
No, how are you gonna get underneath them?
So the mini storm system's actually in the shoulder of the road.
Okay.
So we'd run it along the shoulder of the road, and then the laterals would tie up.
Still have the trucks on blacktop though, maybe?
Currently, there's no blacktop there.
Oh, it's all gravel?
Correct.
Okay. What are you gonna backfill with, slurry?
Slurry or some sort of select backfill.
Yeah, otherwise it's gonna settle.
Correct.
Okay.
I would say slurry, but slurry gets expensive, so.
But it works.
It does, I would agree.
Looks like the project is estimated at $8,500 total, so, and the staff is recommending $4,000.
And I just also want to point out that total cost only extends the mini sewer. Any
mm-hmm.
lateral connections to that sewer would be the requirement of those property owners, and that's not included in that price. So it essentially provide the conduit for those individuals to connect to, but they would still have to connect that discharge to that mini sewer.
Okay. Questions, comments, or a motion? I have a question. Would it be possible, Mike, your motion, to put in there a not to exceed $4,000 from the town standpoint? Is that necessary? Just any other costs above and beyond that would be on those property owners?
I know we had the cost for each property owner not to exceed $1,500, so.
Okay. I see that now.
Our intent was to try to get voluntary agreement to
yep.
waiver a special assessment. So typically what we try to do is set to a not to exceed amount with that.
Yeah.
And it's under our obligation then to ensure that that project comes in under budget.
Okay. And don't worry about it. So motion was stated. Second. Any other questions or comments? Not hearing any. So let's go forward with our vote. Motion was stated to approve the installation of the Crestview South Mini Storm Sewer Extension for a cost to the utility of $4,000. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed say no. Motion carries. 6C is approved. Item 7 is for adjournment. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Motion's been given. I'll give a second. All in favor to adjourn say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed say no. Motion carries. Meeting's adjourned at 7:34 p.m.